टुडे माई टॉपिक इज रोल ऑफ ऑक्यूपेशनल थेरेपी इन ICU. वॉट इज ऑक्यूपेशनल थेरेपी? ऑक्यूपेशनल थेरेपी इज अ क्लाइंट सेंटर्ड हेल्थ प्रोफेशन कंसर्न विद प्रोमोटिंग हेल्थ एंड वेलबींग थ्रू ऑक्यूपेशन. द प्राइमरी गोल ऑफ ऑक्यूपेशनल थेरेपी इज टू इनेबल पीपल टू पार्टिसिपेट इन द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ एवरीडे लाइफ. Then what is occupation? Occupation, in occupational therapy, occupations refers to the everyday activities that people do as individual in families and with communities to occupy time and bring meaning and purpose to life. That is, for example, activities of daily living. Then where occupational therapists work? There are many chances where occupational therapists are work. Occupational therapy work with all age groups and in wide range of physical and psychosocial areas. Places of employment include hospitals, clinics, day and rehabilitation center, home care programs, special school, industry and private enterprise. How occupational therapists work? There are many branches where occupational therapists are work. For example, assessment, planning, intervention and cooperation. So first is assessment. Occupational therapy process is based on initial and repeated assessment. The occupational therapist together with the person they are working with focus on individual and environmental abilities and problems related to activities in the person daily life. Assessment include the use of standardized procedure, for example, standardized test. There are various standardized tests which are assessed in this. So interviews, observation in a variety of settings and consultation with significant people in the person's life. Then next is planning. The planning, what is the meaning of planning? The result of assessment are the basis of the plan which include short and long term aims of treatment. The plan should be revealed to the person development stage, habits, roles, lifestyle, preferences and the environment. In planning there are various goals. So for example, short term goals and long term goals. Then after that, intervention. Intervention focuses on programs that are person oriented and environmental. These are designed to facilitate the performance of everyday tasks and adaptation of settings in which the person work, lives and socializes. The next is cooperation. Occupational therapists recognize the importance of teamwork, cooperation and coordination with other professionals such as medical and other professionals, families, caregivers and volunteers are important in the realization of the holistic approach. Then next is differences between occupational therapy and physiotherapy. So main primary difference between the two is that physiotherapy main focus is gross motor functions, while occupational therapy focuses on how the patient uses fine motor and cognitive skills to perform tasks that are meaningful to them. Then next is PT. Physiotherapists are trained intensively in body mechanics and how different body systems are impacted by motion. Then positioning and exercise. They typically gear intervention toward improving strength, balance and range of motion in order to facilitate body movements. Then occupational therapist primary goal is to help patient engage in activities in areas such as self-care, for example, bathing, toileting, homemaking, leisure, play and socialization. Occupational therapy receives general training across a broad scope of areas. Intervention may include physical exercises but may also focus on areas such as problem solving, memory, organization, keeping a routine, social skill and using community resources and activities of daily living training. Then role of occupational therapy in ICU. According to the American Occupational Therapy Association 2017, the primary goal of acute care is to stabilize the patient medical status and address life-threatening issues. An essential second goal is to improve functional status and safety to prevent physical and cognitive complications, which are also key components of occupational therapy intervention. Then next is a strategy for whole body rehabilitation consisting of interruption of sedation and physical and occupational therapy in the earliest day of critical illness was safe and well tolerated and resulted in better functional outcome at hospital discharge. Occupational therapy in an ICU occupation therapy in ICU improve patient strength, cognition, functional independence in activities of daily living and walking. Early OT intervention which address physical and cognitive rehabilitation and encouragement to participate in meaningful functional activities. Occupational therapy therapists should be involved in intensive care follow-up clinics to assess and facilitate appropriate referrals to further rehabilitation or specialist services and to address any long-term physical and non-physical impairment affecting occupational performance. Then what is the role of OT in NICU? So there are various roles in OT in NICU. NICU means neonatal intensive care unit. First is adapting and modifying the stimuli that premature or newborn baby is exposed to and providing the appropriate stimuli and guidance needed to encourage the development of sensory modulation. Treatment in the areas of eating and feeding to encourage sucking, swallowing and eating skill. Guiding parents to be actively involved in the day-to-day treatment of their premature or newborn baby, such as the use of tactile proprioception and vestibular stimuli, strengthening the infant oral musculature and the function needed for feeding, and assisting and instructing parents on method through which they can continue to function at home and in the NICU simultaneously. What are the assessments involved in ICU? FIM for ADL assessment, functional independent measure for activities of daily living assessment, Lowton instrumental activities of daily living for IADL assessment, MMSC for primary cognitive skills, MoCA for executive functions, cranial nerve examination, mass grading for muscle tone, MMT grading for muscle strength, goniometer for range of motion assessment. Then what are the role of occupational therapy in neurological and general ICU condition? Occupational therapy plays an important role in facilitating early mobilization, restoring functions, preventing further decline in their health condition and coordinating care including transition and discharge planning. Firstly, we have occupational therapist has to evaluate the patient, evaluate the need for splint and other positioning devices to preserve joint integrity and decrease risk of pressure sores due to prolonged bed rest, perform bedside evaluation to promote safety with eating and swallowing. Teach compensatory strategies, technique and use of adaptive equipment for maximizing independence with ADL function in ICU. That is teaching dressing techniques after stroke to improve independence with upper extremity, dressing educating in energy conservation techniques during ADL performance. Then next, evaluate and treat ICU acquired neurological cognitive impairment, for example executive functioning, memory and attention, to improve functional occupation based outcomes. Then recommend home safety modifications during discharge planning. Then after that, upper limb rehab. It includes therapeutic activities and exercises, orthotic design, fabrication, fitting and training, then joint protection or energy conservation techniques in home, work, school or leisure activities. Then next is sensory re-education, mirror therapy, pain management, activity modification, education for post-surgical or post-injury safety including sensory loss. Then next is cognitive assessment and intervention. It includes reorientation, use of suitable assessment tool, that is MMSC and MoCA, patient and family education support, refers to ongoing support services. The next is home assessment and adaptation. It includes recommendation of the home assessment and current level of functions or ongoing needs. It includes referrals to housing or minor major adaptation such as ramping, stair lift, level access bathing facilities. Provision of assistive equipment to facilitate mobility, encouragement of independence and ensure safety.